The natural law that elementary particles follow is governed by the gauge principle. The three forces, strong force, weak force, and electromagnetic force, excluding gravity, can be understood in a unified manner by the gauge principle, even though they have very different properties. This video gives an overview of the standard model described as SU3 cross SU2 cross U1 gauge theory. Here is a summary of the important consequences of gauge invariance. 1. In order to satisfy the gauge invariance, a new quantity, that is, the introduction of a gauge field, is inevitably required. 2. The gauge field that emerges according to the demands of gauge invariance is the source of the force between particles. It can be interpreted that a force acts between particles to keep the gauge invariance. 3. Gauge invariance is guaranteed by replacing the derivative with the covariant derivative. Therefore, the minimal coupling prescription uniquely determines the interaction between the gauge field and the particles. In the natural world, there are baryons, protons, neutrons, etc., consisting of three quarks, and mesons, pions, etc., consisting of quark and antiquark pairs, and the force acting between these quarks is strong force. So far, six types of quarks have been discovered, and each quark has 3 degrees of freedom called color. The quark wave function under the SU3 gauge transformation follows an invariant Dirac equation. Along with this SU3 gauge invariance, there is a SU3 gauge field called gluon, and the derivative is replaced by the covariant derivative. Here, G3 is a coupling constant that represents the strength of the SU3 gauge interaction. Just as the electromagnetic force acts between charged particles by mediating photons, the strong force acts by mediating gluons between quarks. It is known that the electromagnetic interaction and the weak interaction are unified and described by the electroweak theory or the SU2 cross U1 Y gauge theory called Weinberg-Salam theory. SU2 gauge fields are represented using Pauli matrices. Left-handed quarks and leptons form a pair to form the SU2 doublet. The doublet has SU2 gauge convertibility. Here, G2 is a coupling constant that represents the strength of the SU2 gauge interaction. On the other hand, right-handed quarks and leptons are invariant under the SU2 gauge transformation, so the derivative remains the same. Therefore, the left-handed component of the quark and lepton interacts with the SU2 gauge field, and the right-handed component does not. Since it is the same type of U1 gauge invariance as the electromagnetic interaction, if the U1Y charge, hypercharge, is given to each quark and lepton, the U1Y gauge interaction will be determined as a covariant derivative. G1 is the U1Y gauge coupling constant, and Y is the U1Y charge measured in units of G1. B is the gauge field associated with the U1Y gauge invariance. Since the conversion of quarks and leptons is given to each of the gauge groups SU3, SU2, and U1Y, it is completely decided what equation the quarks and leptons follow. We write equations for first-generation quarks and leptons. Exactly the same equation holds for second- and third-generation quarks and leptons. The color subscripts for the U and D quarks are omitted here to avoid complications. Gluon G interacts only with quarks and does not distinguish between left-handed L and right-handed R. The gauge field W of SU2 binds only to doublet left-handed quarks and left-handed leptons, and does not interact with singlet right-handed quarks and right-handed leptons. The U1Y gauge field, B, binds to each quark and lepton in proportion to the magnitude of the U1Y charge Y. Since W and B are bonded differently between left-handed and right-handed quarks and leptons, it can be seen that they break the spatial inversion invariance. This is the origin of parity violations. If you take a closer look at all the equations, you will notice an important fact. There is no mass term in any equation. To have Dirac mass, both left-handed and right-handed chirality are required. However, this term breaks the SU3 cross SU2 cross U1Y gauge invariance of the equation. In other words, the mass terms of quarks and leptons are prohibited due to the request for SU3 cross SU2 cross U1Y gauge invariance. However, we know that in reality both electrons and quarks have mass. In this regard, we need to wait for the discussion of spontaneous breaking of symmetry. There, the mass origins of quarks and leptons are clarified. The requirement for gauge invariance imposes strong restrictions on the equations that quarks and leptons follow. The gauge principle plays a role as a guiding principle that determines the ideal form of a law of nature. What is not described by the gauge principle? Gauge theory does not answer anything about gauge groups. A larger group, such as SU1 million, would have been fine, but nature has modestly adopted the smaller gauge group SU3×SU2×U1Y. Nature seems to be satisfied with just a handful of quarks and leptons. Clarifying what the gauge principle does not describe is one of the remaining issues in particle physics.